Welcome, RPA champions. Today's video is going to be pretty amazing. We are going to be building an AI automation that is going to be a coding assistant. We're going to be using Flowise, which is a free technology that I have showed you in an extensive video how to set up and how to get started with. If you want the link to that video, it is going to be up right above. Now, let's get down to business. Different chat engines, such as, for example, ChatGPT, they suck or sometimes they hallucinate when they're giving you code. So right now I'm trying to create a Gradio app that is using GPT 3.5. However, I am getting wrong code all of the time. I have also tried to ask the same question to Gemini to see if it does any better. However, it is still giving me wrong code. And again, I have tried also Anthropic, the newest Claude 3 Opus system. Again, I am getting a slightly wrong code. I have tried Mistral Chat as well, asking the same question. And again, it is hallucinating and giving me a wrong code. These models have a pretty bad idea with knowledge that has been updated recently. Therefore, you either give it that knowledge it's yourself, or you teach it some other way by inserting it inside of the prompt. With Flowise, we're going to be creating a assistant that is going to go over a bunch of different documents and is going to read those documents that are going to be the guides on different things, that different guides on README files, on different coding libraries, and we are going to test or upload these documents into our assistant. Let me show you how it's going to look. We're going to have a conversation retrieval Q&A chain, and we're going to ask it, for example, to create a Gradio app. We're going to ask it to create a Gradio app with GPT-4, and it's going to output only code because that's how we programmed it to be. It is also going to be referencing the documents that we have given it for reference and to get the newest code so that it doesn't hallucinate and doesn't get old, unupdated code. So it is going to be a really, really great assistant. So in just a few steps, we're going to start from a blank canvas, but in just a few steps, we're going to be creating a really cool, powerful AI assistant that is going to be better than ChatGPT Grimoire. Right now, I'm not just using ChatGPT 4, I'm using a custom or one of the best programming GPTs. It's going to be better than Gemini, Anthropic, Mistral, and so on. Why? Because it's going to have exactly the knowledge that you need. And I'm going to get to that in a second. But let's start. Let's start with our chat, or let's start with our assistant creation. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a chain. Everything starts in chain, in LangChain. That's even the name, LangChain, chains. And we're going to add OpenAI chat, OpenAI. Now, after that, we are going to add a chain. So let's add a chain. Multi-retrieval Q&A chain, prompt chain. So what we need is a multi-retrieval Q&A chain. So this chain is going to connect to this language model that we have created or that we have added. And inside of here, we're going to add our OpenAI key. We're also going to lower this temperature because we don't want it to be too creative. So we're going to just put it at 0.1. And we're going to select a better model. After that, we are going to add a vector store retriever. So vector store retriever is going to allow us to upload some documents into our chat. What do I mean upload some documents? Now we are creating an agent that is going to be analyzing some documents. So it is as simple as going to vector store retriever, as it says right here, over down here, and we're going to be using in-memory vector store because this is going to be on our machine. If we wanted to upload this on a server, there's plenty of different connections that we can use, and if you want, I can show you how to use it with Chroma, with Pinecone, with Postgres. I have used all of these different examples to retrieve different kinds of information stored on different places. But this time we're going to be storing it on our computer, so we're going to be using in-memory vector store. The in-memory vector store, we're going to connect it here, and this I believe requires embeddings and some documents. So let's add some embeddings. Embeddings are going to give meaning to the assistant about our documents. So the embeddings are just going to be called embeddings here, and we're going to add the OpenAI embeddings, because that's the OpenAI key that we are currently using. So let's go to OpenAI, set it up and connect it to the embeddings. We can also select different models that we want. This is the newest model. Also, we have the documents. So what kind of document do we want to analyze and ask questions about? So let's go to the documents right here, and we have all kinds of different documents. We can upload single documents, documents from different libraries, from different APIs. We're going to upload a folder that contains different documents or different guides that are going to be different guides to the documentation that we need for our assistant to be trained on. So we need the most up-to-date OpenAI documentation, the most up-to-date Gradio documentation, the most up-to-date LangChain documentation, and yeah, this is what we need so far, because this is the kind of assistant that I want to build. You could upload any kind of document, your CV, a really long document, all of your research papers, your taxes, your Excel files, or anything that you need insight on, or that you need to create a report on or generate some text about. So we are going to connect this to our document, and also we have the ability to add a text splitter here. So text splitter is going to take our documents and break them into different chunks, allowing the GPT model to understand it better. Now, we should do this only if our documents are of a certain size. I know that my guides are relatively small, and I think that they can fit inside of the context prompt, so I'm not going to be using a text splitter. However, I have to give it a folder path. These are all of the different documents that I want to use. So these are just TXT files. I scraped different pages and I got these documents. So just to show you, it is just some text and also some code that shows me how to create different things. So I'm going to just copy this because I will be using it later on. Let's close this and let's add the path to our folder right here. So we are going to get all of the files that are inside of this folder. So our model is almost complete. Let's see if we need anything else. We have a language model, we have a in-memory vector store, and a folder with files. However, there is one problem. We're just using a multi-retrieval Q&A chain, but what we actually want is to use a chat version instead. So let's go to the chains one more time, and multi-retrieval Q&A chain, retrieval Q&A chain. Let's see if we have conversational retrieval Q&A chain. So this is actually what we want. Let's delete this one and connect these steps to the chat model, connect this to the vector store. And right now we don't need any memory because we're going to be using by default the buffer memory of our computer. So we don't need to use any, we don't need to connect anything else. In addition to this, so before we test our connection, we can save our flow and let's give it a meaningful name. And let's save it. And before we can test it, we have to upsert all of the information. This means that I'm going to show you in a second. This means that we have to, let's change the API keys. Make sure that we have the correct API key set up. And let's try this again. So what does this mean? This means that it is going to chunk this information like this, and it is going to reference each of the information so that the model is going to know where to search for the information and from where to get the information. Now, if we use the text splitter, we would have created many different chunks based on the size of the text splitter. So for example, 500 tokens, 1000 tokens, and so on. So this should be working right now, but before we test it, let me show you one final thing that is crucial for this to work. So in the additional parameters, Flowise is so great that it has provided a great instruction prompt for us to get started. This instruction prompt, it is going to make sure that everything that we ask the model, it is going to reference to the documents that we have uploaded and not hallucinate or just provide random information. Let me read it for you for a second. I want you to act as a document that I'm having a conversation with. Your name is AI assistant. Using the provided context, answer the questions in the best of your ability using the resources provided. If there is nothing in the context relevant to the questions at hand, just say, I'm not sure, and stop after, etc., etc., not important. Then we have the context that we insert as a variable. And in the end, we also have another note for the AI, which tells it to answer I'm not sure, so it doesn't hallucinate, and also never to break character. And let's add one more thing, output only code. So it doesn't give us explanation, but it just outputs only the code. So this is where we can add the instructions for our assistant to behave, if we want it to be a coding assistant, if we want it to be whatever we want. So let's save this and let's test our automation, or let's test our AI agent. Hey, I want to create a Gradio app with GPT 3.5. So right now, if it doesn't find this information anywhere, so it didn't find this information anywhere, I'm not sure. I think it's because I wrote this all together, but let's try. So I'm actually happy that this is the result. Let's add a space here and see if it finds 3.5 somewhere in the text. It should find it. So let's try one more time and let's add a Gradio. So I misspelled this. A Gradio app with GPT 3.5. Let's continue with this and see if it gets it right. So, all right, I misspelled it, so that's why it didn't get it correct, but it is using the correct formulation just like I have inside of my document. Now, if I wanted to ask it something like, for example, update this with LangChain, it would reference the documents, so it hasn't referenced the documents. But let's make sure that if we put this return source documents to on, this is going to reference all of the documents that are going to be retrieved. So let's save this and let's try something else. So add LangChain to this code. All right, now I have spelled it correctly. Let's see if it is going to work. All right, once you spell the things correctly, it finds the document. So in this case, it checked all of those documents. It didn't find it. Now we are using LangChain, and let's see how it is going to build it. Well, it has just added LangChain, but it is not using it anywhere, but that's because I haven't really given it information on how to use it. However, if I asked this information right here to all of the different models, it would have given me a hallucinated answer, meaning that it would have given me wrong information right here. It would have been giving me also wrong information right here using different models, and so on. So this is how easy it is. In just a couple of minutes, we were able to create a create automation, or just pretty much anything, any files that we want. Now, if you like this video, make sure that you put a thumbs up down below, and also that you subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any more crazy and cool automations like this. If you also have some ideas on what kind of automations you would like to see and what kind of AI agents that you would like to see, please leave it down in the comments below. I would love to create them together with you. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.